Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's 9:30 a.m. Friday the 18th of January, and we're back from our Christmas holiday. We hope you all had a wonderful holiday and are all fired up for 2019. We are.
Yes, so. Absolutely. We've had a wonderful time and hope you have too. I've got Rob working, mind you. I've had him working like a Trojan. So he's decorated all the house and it looks fabulous. So thank you very much, Rob. You're much appreciated. You can have a holiday now.
Thank you very much. Oops, yes.
Your guest has arrived.
Oh, the guest has arrived.
Oh, Jenny. Hi. I
wonder when you guys would clip that we knew each other.
That's, I knew we knew you. Okay. All right. So I just want to, before we meet our guest, I've just got a little bit of information here for you. I would like you all to be at the Heart for Arts in High Street, Carterton, at 5:30 tonight, because there's going to be an exhibition of landscape paintings by Margaret Crawford and some photography from, who's that guy? Rob Innes. And so it's going to be a fabulous exhibition. So come along at 5:30 this evening and have a look. And I think we get, do we get nibbles and drinks? I don't know. I'm not sure about that.
Heart of the Arts is High Street, isn't it?
Yes, yeah, it is. High Street there. Yeah. So get yourself along to that. They're both local artists. So it'll be wonderful to meet them too. They're both wonderful people. So get yourself along there. And good morning, Jenny.
Sorry, I'm slightly late.
That's
no,
all right.
Not a problem.
This is local TV as well as radio. So, we're all country folk. And so this is how it cruises.
Wairarapa time, as they say.
Yes, absolutely.
That's it, yeah.
All right.
Right, Jenny Gusson. Are we pronouncing that correctly?
You are indeed, yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've been called worse. So don't worry.
I can imagine, but I'm not going to go there.
So you're in charge of Wings over Wairarapa for this year.
Yeah,
wow.
Indeed.
So how's it all going?
Oh, it's looking amazing. Mm-hmm. Thanks. Yeah, so we have really shaken things up this time. Mm-hmm. We are, you've probably heard we've invited all of the local Wairarapa schools along.
Okay.
On the Friday. Uh-huh. Normally our Friday's pretty quiet. You know, it's mainly planes arriving and doing a bit of practice. But this time we thought, well, let's open it up to the schools.
Yeah.
They're going to come along and they're actually going to be speaking to a whole lot of exhibitors that work specifically around science, technology and engineering and aviation. So really great opportunity for them. And we've got 4,500 children registered.
Wow.
Yeah.
What's the age group going from kindy?
Right, from five. We've cut it off at five, right the way up.
Right through to
senior. Yeah, senior schools. So really excited about that. So that's the Friday, which will be a massive day. And then obviously there's the air show proper on the Saturday and Sunday. It's looking really good.
Yeah.
Really, really exciting.
Oh, fantastic. Mm. So how many years has it been going?
Oh, well, this it's actually been going for years and years and years, but in its kind of current form, this is our 20th year, so 10 sort of official Wings over Wairarapa shows.
Yeah, this is when we can think back to because we went along, you know, when it first started, because it was so amazing.
Yeah.
But I didn't realise it was before then.
It has. I mean, the guys have been involved for years, but sort of, you know, sometimes on a smaller scale, more like, you know, flying weekend sort of situations. Uh-huh. But yeah, the first proper one was 99, so this makes it our 20th anniversary.
Oh, fantastic.
We've just got a small technical problem. So I'm going to go and get the station manager to come and have a look at this. Oh. So carry on.
Okay. We'll carry on. No, we'll carry on as normal.
Yeah.
Carry on, don't panic. So how many aircraft are there in this Wings over Wairarapa?
So we're looking at around 70.
Yeah.
Which is, funnily enough, the exact same number that were at the first one.
Oh, good
heavens. Which is really cute.
Yeah.
But, you know, a different variety of aircraft, obviously.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so 70 of various ages, right from, you know, the early 1900s right through to today, basically.
So you're going right through, like, way back
way back. We're very fortunate.
So biplanes and all that.
Yeah, biplanes and triplanes and all sorts of things. So we're very, very fortunate to have the Vintage Aviator out at Hood, and they're working with us really closely.
Mm-hmm. Oh, fantastic.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
And the CAA are involved as well.
Yep, CAA always involved in anything to do with the shows, and they're amazing to work with. Actually, they're really helpful with us and guidance, and yeah. We don't do it if they say don't do it. So that's how it works.
So who organises Wings Over Wairarapa to start with? How does it begin?
So you mean on a sort of year to year basis?
Yep.
So we have there's a whole load of people involved in it. We've got the most amazing team, a great bunch of people to work with. So we have a board of trustees who look after the governance side of things. Surprisingly enough, Bob Francis is our chair. So he's been involved since 2011. And then we have a really great governance board as well. And then I am contracted by the board to sort of oversee the event, so to, you know, do the operational side of things. And then we have as I said, a fantastic team. Chris Tracy does all our exhibitions and
She's still involved, is
she? She's still involved. She started off doing the volunteers, and we've given her this new challenge. It was I don't want to say her fault, but it was her idea for the STEM day, which is exciting. Yvonne Way does our marketing and business development. Rachel Dell is our new volunteer manager. We've got Vanessa Jane doing accommodation, and then we have all the amazing actual people who do the aircraft. So people like Tom Williams, who's been involved. I mean, he started it. You know, John Lanham, who does the programming. Look, the list goes on. We've got about counting volunteers, we have about 400 people that run the show.
Good heavens.
So that's volunteers, pilot staff.
That's amazing trustees. For a small area, isn't it,
It is amazing, and we're so fortunate. And a lot of those are volunteers. And then we have a really great core team as well that works for the 2 years prior to the show. So I'm sure I've forgotten somebody. I'm sure I have. Somebody really important.
Out of 400 people.
They'll forgive you, I'm sure.
But no, I'm very fortunate. It's a great team.
So how did you yourself get involved?
As with many things in the Wairarapa, it's kind of who you know, I guess. I was asked to do some, just start off taking minutes for the board after the 2013 show. My background is events and project management and that side of things and recruitment. And as it turned out, Liz, who ran so many successful shows prior to that, decided that 2013 would be her last year, and I think right place, right time, and away you go.
Tremendous. Right, do you want to ask a couple of questions there, Rob? I'm kind of leaving you out.
No, you're carry on. You're doing a great job. But, you know, Masterton, what got to be one of the smallest airports in the country?
I don't know whether David Hayes would appreciate me saying maybe. It's actually, we've very fortunate. It's an amazing resource to have, and I know that David, who's the airport manager, and the council are looking to develop that resource quite a lot. They're looking at, I think, building some hangar homes down there and turning it into a real, you know, centre of aviation. And we're very lucky with, as I mentioned before, the Vintage Aviator. Oh, just such a great resource. I know there's work there to turn that into a bigger attraction as well. So, yeah, don't know if it is the smallest, actually.
Well, it's got to be one of.
One of, probably, but no, it's a...
Apart from those with dirt runways.
I was in Abel Tasman for some of the holidays, and we came across a runway in someone's backyard. Making Hood look quite sizable, really,
But it seems, you know, for an airport that size... To have wings over Wairarapa.
I take your point,
What makes it so great for Wings over Wairarapa?
I think, to be honest, it was all down to Tom Williams and his team who started off there. You know, said, well, I think we can do this, and they did it, and then it's just grown from there. We've got the space to be able to have a reasonable size audience, you know. We can fit thousands thousands of people in there. I think where it is works to its advantage, as you said, 400 people locally that want to volunteer or help out. We are so lucky. So yeah. I think
yeah, they're very giving, aren't they?
Yeah, people yeah.
In the Wairarapa, yeah. Extremely giving of their time and yeah.
Yeah.
So I guess we ought to remind listeners when the show is.
That's a good point, Rob. So it's from the we've actually changed the date. It's funny, I was looking out the window this morning because traditionally it's been at Wellington Anniversary Weekend, so that would be this weekend coming. Yeah. But we've actually moved it to the end of February, mm-hmm. so it's the 22nd to 24th of February. Yeah, mm-hmm. One of the reasons we did that is supposedly the weather is a little bit more stable. You know, yes, at the moment it's just crazy, isn't it? Well, crazy
yeah.
weather.
Yeah, it's always like that, isn't it? You know, after Christmas. And,
it's just nuts. And I think this will, you know, with whatever's happening with, you know, the environment, that will probably change mm-hmm. as we go through the years. But the other reason we changed it to the end of February is that it's closer to Avalon, which is a massive air show in Australia. And we're hoping eventually we'll be able to work with them on getting.
So the aircraft move across to Australia at the end of our show.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's there.
We were watching a program last night, The Last Flight of the Vulcan.
Oh, right.
It's a pity we haven't got one of those.
Yeah. Absolutely amazing. It did its last flight.
Oh.
It was quite sad. They were all quite sad, weren't they?
Yeah.
It's like looking at, you know, your loved one, you know, your sick loved one. They were really emotional, weren't they?
Well, Tufty engineer. Completely attached to this bomber.
Yeah.
I can understand
they
why.
All were.
He knew how it worked. He was one of the only people that did it.
Yeah. It was an amazing program.
Yeah. Oh, awesome.
Maybe we have a music break now.
We will. We'll take a music break.
Yeah.
I know I'm going to play a very appropriate tune, I think.
Yeah.
So
okay.
If I can remember all how to do it. AUX. There we go. And those three off. No, we're going to play The Magnificent Men and Their Flying Machine.
Yes.
From the 1965 film by the same name.
Yeah.
And it's got a lot of characters that. A lot of characters in it that you'll all remember. And I've just switched my mic off by accident. So here we go.
No, we haven't. That's fine.
There we go, folks. We are back with Arrow FM 92.7. Hope you enjoyed that one from way back in 1965.
Yeah.
And that was from... Who released that one? It was some well-known organisation called 20th Century Fox.
Yeah. And it was... Was there a movie? I think they made a movie of it.
It was indeed a movie released in 1965.
Yeah.
With notable names like Benny Hill.
Yeah.
Eric Sykes.
All the great comedians.
Terry Thomas. Mm. And a whole bunch of other people.
Yeah. Brilliant.
So
anyway.
We're back with Jenny Gusson. We're talking with the organiser of Wings Over Wairarapa.
Yeah. So next into the questions then, we've got... now, what organisation participate in the Wings Over Wairarapa?
Sure. So this is going to be another one of those ones where I'm sure I forget to mention somebody very important.
Well, they've got to be about 400.
Yeah. So we work with a lot of organisations. Look, everybody from our funders, so Trust House is a major funder and they're just brilliant. They're so supportive. Mm-hmm. And we have all of our sponsors. So our big naming rights sponsor is a Swiss aircraft manufacturer called Pilatus.
Okay.
Yeah. And then we have, you know, other sponsors on top of that, Mitre 10, Seller and Seller locally.
Great.
You know, they're so great. Boeing, Lockheed Martin. We've got a lot of great sponsors this year. Mm. We've also have worked with, you know, on the volunteer side, all the Rotaries.
Mm-hmm.
So we have great relationships with all the Rotaries right across Wairarapa.
Yeah, they're all very supportive.
They are amazing, absolutely. But, you know, it's just one of our key relationships is the Sport and Vintage Aviation Society. Mm-hmm. So they've got a museum down at Hood Aerodrome and they've got a wonderful cafe that runs on the weekends and you can go and do adventure flying there as well. And they do our aircraft side of things and they're all headed up by Tom, who I've mentioned before. Gosh, I could go on and on. I mean, we've got an electrician, Joe Quirks, our electrician, Toby Mills does our sound. You know, lots and lots of different organisations.
You've no idea what it entails, really. Something like that, some major event like that. It's amazing.
It is, it is. But no, we're very, very fortunate.
You want me to come nearer? Okay, now what about the ticket pricing?
Yeah.
What are we doing for that?
Yeah, so...
What's it going to cost us?
So what's it going to cost you? So... we have a variety of ticket prices and we've done it because we need to cover our costs. So we have to have a certain price, you know, to help us do that. And we've also, what we've also done is try to look at different options to different people because we realise that sometimes that price, you know, people can't afford it. So we have for example, on the Friday, the price is substantially reduced. So you can come in and have a look at the aircraft. It's a half a day, so you know, if you're not wanting to spend a whole day there, it's a fantastic option. And you've got adult, children and family prices available. The Saturday is our most expensive day. So for example, it's $75 for an adult to go, but that gets you entertainment from 8 o'clock in the morning till 10 o'clock at night.
It is 14
hours. So per hour it's not bad, but look, we realise that not everybody's got that money to spend. And so what we've done this time is we have a night show. So it's instead of 75, it's 45. You get to go for the night show. You get to experience the aircraft and see the fireworks and everything. And it's that little bit, you know.
So that's from 6 till 10.
That's from 6 till 10. So, and then we have a Sunday price for the whole Sunday, which is 65, I think, from the top of my head.
$60.
Yeah, so, and we've got different options. So, for example, if you really want to go out and spend, you know, be in a marquee and have it catered and everything, there is an option for that.
Yeah.
Or if you just want to bring along your own picnic, sit on a chair and watch the planes, there's an option for that as well. So we realise that not everybody can afford to do this, but we've, you know, tried to accommodate. And we've also done a local price. A local deal this time. So And we'll be releasing this again. We did it in November and we had pretty good take up on it. And basically what it does is you buy a Sunday ticket and then you get a night show ticket for free.
Oh,
okay.
Just for locals, okay. Just for Wairarapa.
Oh, right. Mm. So do you have to take some kind of information along that you are a Wairarapa resident?
We're doing it through the eyesight, so they're pretty good at spotting. Spotting someone who's not. And to be, you know... Yeah.
Since you got to keep us awake anyway on Saturday.
Yeah. I know. 9:30. It's funny, isn't it, when 9:30 sounds like a late night. I'd love to be tucked up in bed by then, but it's going to be such a great night show.
Yeah.
We've got gliders coming from the UK who effectively shoot fireworks out of their wings, just...
Like Spitfires.
Yeah. We've got fire service on hand, but it's a beautiful show. So.
Okay. So where do the tickets come? Where had we get them?
So you can go to various places. A lot of people like to go to the eyesights because they give such good advice from the eyesights. You can talk to the ladies there in Masterton and Martinborough. You can also get them online. So go via our website, which is wings.org.nz, or straight to Ticket Direct.
Mm-hmm.
All of those options.
Ticket
yeah.
Direct this time, not the other one.
It's been Ticket Direct for the last three shows, this show and the last two before, but I know.
Okay, so we do see that there's a silver pass and a gold pass.
Yeah, there is a silver pass and a gold pass. So what we've done, the gold pass is the fully catered hospitality experience. Okay. So you're right on the flight line. You get your meals. You have seating. There's marquee cover. It's the, you know, deluxe of the deluxe. We've actually, on the Saturday, we've sold out of those. Which is incredible. We've never done that before. And we've had to... limit the numbers. But you can still get into the area on a Saturday, but you need to buy a three-day ticket. That's all we've got left. But you can get a gold pass to the Sunday, which is a wonderful experience. It's a little bit quieter on the Sunday, so that's a bit more relaxed. The silver pass, we introduced that this time because there are people who just want a seat in shade, and they want it to be easy, and they just want to turn up and sit there. Yeah. And we didn't really have an option for them. Shade is an issue for us.
Shade's a big issue
for us, and for everybody in an airfield. Yeah. And we've addressed that somewhat this time, but we've also got that silver pass area.
Okay, that's the silver pass, is it? Okay.
So that's undercover seating.
Yeah. That's undercover seating, but no food provided. But and it's guaranteed. Problem we have is we have shade marquees around, but we just can't guarantee them for the volume of people. Mm. So
if it's seat only, can they bring a picnic, or do they need to go to the local?
Oh, they can bring a picnic. That's fine. And we have a lot of food stalls there, and they're great. You know, we've got a really loyal food truck, I guess, suppliers. But bring a picnic because, you know, it's another cost saving for you, and it's quite nice to sit around.
Now, what about wine? Where you were like, not
you can't bring alcohol in just because of the licensing.
People want to know that. Otherwise, you'll be turned away.
We'll just take the wine off you, essentially. You just sort of take it back to the car. It's probably the easiest. We do have a bar on site. It's not a big drinking event.
To ask the question because a lot of people do go along with their drink as in their picnic baskets naturally.
They
expect to be able to, but a lot of law now you can't do
it's just
that.
A condition of the license.
Absolutely.
So
now, are there door sales?
Well, that's a very interesting question. Traditionally I would say absolutely turn up on the day and you'll be able to get a gate sale. I think I have to be careful how I say this. I think with the volume of tickets we've sold so far and the interest we've seen on social media, particularly for the night show, I can't guarantee that.
So numbers are limited.
They have to be. We've got a lot of space out there, but you know, we want to make sure people have a good experience. So hiring tickets for, I don't know, 15,000 people and then letting 25,000 people in the door. Hiring toilets for 15,000 people.
Of course, it's what the other thing.
Yeah, and letting 25,000 people in the door is not a good experience for people. So my advice to people who think they're going to be able to buy a ticket on the gate, no problem at all, is to keep an eye on our website, wings.org.nz, or our Facebook page, Wings Over Wairarapa. We'll know closer to the time.
Yeah.
At this stage, yes, gate sales, but there may be that position where we have to cap it.
Mm. So you heard it here, folks. Buy now or you could be disappointed.
It's a tough one because we just don't know right now.
And what about a rain day?
What happens if the rain turns ugly?
Well, as you may remember, we're reasonably practiced in rain days. 2017, a very sad occasion for us all because we had to cancel the whole show. That is really unusual. You know, usually you get one day of rain and you can, you know, see it coming and therefore you work around that. Mm-hmm. We've got all our cancellation terms on the website, but basically... we only have that Sunday as our rain day. If Saturday's rained out, we'll move it all to the Sunday. If the whole weekend's cancelled, then we refund. I think we were very successful last time. I think, you know, we had the odd person who didn't get their refund straight away, and we sorted that out.
Because you've moved just it to a later date, there will be no rain.
A lot of people keep saying to me, "Oh, well, it can't possibly happen again." And I think, "Oh, that's really cute, but do you not know how the weather works?" You know. So, look, we are more aware than anybody about what happens if it rains.
You need to have a chat with Dan, do you?
Yeah.
Dan the man. Now, when these aircraft are out on the field, and then are you allowed inside them at all?
No. Some of these aircraft are worth millions of dollars, and the owners are, you know, bring them along pretty much out of the goodness of their heart. And there are the odd aircraft owner that will let you do that. The Air Force is pretty good actually at letting you in things, but no, it's quite hard to get.
Because of the volume of people too. It just wouldn't be on. So it's just to let people know that they can view them. From a distance, but there's no way.
There is we have some fantastic people down at Hood who own hangars who actually bring their own aircraft out on display, and sometimes they're pretty open to that. But it's just a case of having a chat when you're there. But no, the majority you won't be able to get inside.
We were lucky enough in England when we went to England last year, and one of my dearest friends, he was in the Air Force, but he's a mechanical engineer and what have you. So therefore, we were allowed to go to Lincoln, wasn't it?
Yes.
Lincoln Airfield.
Near Lincoln, yes.
Oh, wow.
And we went on a Spitfire.
Yeah.
And the bomber.
Gosh. Wow. The
two bombers.
The two bombers.
I can't remember what the smaller one was.
Yeah. But... and they still fly. Aircraft still fly. But just to be, and of course, everybody else weren't allowed.
In a Lancaster.
They were, you know, behind the
Lancaster.
We were in a Lancaster bomber.
But Lancaster bomber. That's what we went in. And we took photos and stuff. It was amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it was such a privilege for us to be allowed on them because. And the mechanics of them inside, they just... do they fly? How do they have the knowledge to fly these machines?
I bet there's going to be a lot of your listeners right now who are very jealous. Very jealous of you.
We were very fortunate.
They're not as comfortable as a 747.
So the age of these planes you're going to have there at the show then, they range from,
I think I know I'm going to say this wrong. I think the earliest we've got is about 1914.
Okay.
But we're just in the process of confirming which ones we'll have from the Vintage Aviator. Yeah. They've been so generous this time. They have basically opened up just about their whole collection to us. It's the only place in the world where you'll see these aircraft.
Fantastic. What about Peter Jackson? Is he going to be putting any in from his collection?
Peter Jackson's collection is the Vintage Aviator. He's very...
Oh, so just to see that, amazing. Yeah. It would be amazing.
Yep.
You see them flying with those canvas wings and...
Wooden
frame.
You wonder how they even got off the ground, eh?
Yeah.
You wonder how they stayed up in the air.
Well, they do. I mean, you sort of... we've got a number of our pilots are... pilot for Peter Jackson in the Vintage Aviator, and they were out, some of them were out flying yesterday, and yeah, it just looks like those magnificent men in their flying machines.
So will they be flying every day, those oldies?
It's very weather dependent, and also some of them are so old that, that no they won't, but you will be able to get up close and sort of see them, you know, take some great photos. We generally have about, I think it's about an hour and a half of Vintage Aviator aircraft on each day. So the idea is yes, but they are quite weather dependent. But we've had people travel from halfway around the world just to see them, you know, parked up.
The only place you can go and see a Vulcan now is in Doncaster.
Oh, really? Of all places.
That's it, folks. Yeah.
Doncaster.
That's the only one left in existence.
Yeah.
And that is just run out onto the taxiway now and then to make sure the engines still work. And that's it. It's put back in the barn.
So what other displays will you be having at the air show?
At the air show, apart from the aircraft? It's... it's got massive this time. So we've relied on food and kids' entertainment and exhibitors and things. This time, Chris, who I was talking about before, has organised this amazing education program, and that will go on for all 3 days. So, for example, we've got the Royal New Zealand, the Air Force coming with, I think they're bringing 80 people to talk to people about the Air Force and careers and looking at the different technology that they use. So we've got them. We've got everything from virtual reality goggles that people can try on.
Oh, I love those.
They're very cool, very fun. We've got rocketry workshops. So if you've got a child who's keen on rockets, you can actually sign up via a website. I haven't done that quite yet. It'll be a couple of weeks. And do a rocketry workshop at the show.
All these little boys and little girls are going to love that.
It's fantastic. We've got what else have we got? We've got Masterson Libraries coming along and bringing some circuitry workshops. We've got Fab Lab coming for digital fabrication. Oh, look, the list goes. It's amazing. Oh. We've got Airbus and Boeing and Lockheed. They've all bought these displays and they're going to talk to people about that kind of thing. We've got careers. People from aviation. It's gosh, it's lots and lots of entertainment. I know that people like to come to the air show, but sometimes, you know, looking in the sky for 8 hours a day is hard work, so we've got a lot to keep people entertained,
Especially children.
New Zealand jet modellers are coming. So they fly, and when I say model airplanes, they're not these, you know, little ones that you have in your backyard. They are massive. They can do some simulations here as well.
Let's hope nobody flies any drones across the state.
No, we don't have any drones, do we?
We actually will have drones there, but ours are under CAA controls. It's an interesting subject. I think they're an important part of the aviation industry, but
But the operators need to know what they're doing. They did at Gatwick was unforgivable.
Parking.
Yes.
We've got lots and lots of parking space.
Parking's always a challenge. Traditionally, we've parked a lot of people in the Solway Crescent area. There's now a lot of housing in there, so we've actually had to reshuffle our entire parking plan. We'll be putting that up on the website, though, and we've actually got a meeting about traffic management and parking and things this morning.
Traffic management 101, is it?
But, I mean, my message out to people in the Wairarapa is, look, we know it can be a bit of a pain for people in the Wairarapa for Wings Weekend. We do get a lot of cars. We just want to say thank you for your patience, and we are doing everything we possibly can to make that as easy as possible for local people.
So what about camper vans? A lot of people that travel the country go to these sort of places. They do. Is there room for those people?
So we already have 200 camper vans signed up, which is fantastic, because that's sort of normally the maximum we get for the show. But we have a system whereby if you buy a 3-day pass, you can actually park for free in the motorhome parking area at the aerodrome, but they have to be self-contained motorhomes.
Yes.
So how many can you accommodate, Jenny?
I think, well, we'd just reshuffle, we're good at shuffling things around to fit, but I think we could probably fit 400 if we really had to.
Okay, so there's still plenty of room.
Yeah, there's still plenty of room, but get in soon. But I think we cut off registrations for motorhomes on the 12th, of February, just to make sure we've got enough space. Yeah.
But remember what we said about tickets, folks. If you haven't got a ticket now, it's a good idea.
Yeah.
So let's get on finally now for the volunteer roles. I mean, there still must be a lot of spaces that need filling.
Yeah.
For that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. So what are you looking? Who are you looking for?
Gosh, we're looking just about, how long's a piece of string, Val? We look for everybody from people who are able to work computers and sell tickets. Mm-hmm. It's not just about, taking cash anymore or FPOS. It's about being able to work the system out so you can print the right ticket and that kind of thing. So we look for ticket sellers. We look for people who can scan tickets, parking people, we have administration people that we look for, drivers. We're particularly keen to get some truck drivers if there's anyone out there.
So they've got to have an L2 or an L.
With a truck license.
So what do you want the truck drivers for?
So we have water trucks that travel around the show.
Oh, okay.
And they're really important because obviously it gets quite hot and we need to water down the ground but also fill water tankers up. And we need people that can do that. So
there's a guy at Tamarua that can do that.
Yeah. Is it all right? I'll look him up.
Okay.
Yeah. One of the really big things we look for is people to help after the event. We're so lucky with people during the event, but one of the things is in that week after the event, everybody disappears, which they do. The air show's done. That's actually where a lot of our work is done, and we have sort of one or two people who turn up and help every day. But we could do with some more.
Okay.
And we can, we give people things like you get a cap and a T-shirt, but also you could get tickets to the show if you're willing to help us do that. Yeah. So we do, we can't pay, but we do reward people. But, pretty much, if you're interested in volunteering, we've got a web page, wings.org.nz/volunteers.
Yeah.
You can register your interest and our volunteer manager, Rachel, we'll be in touch to sort you out a job.
And it's a great thing to do. We've done a lot around the area.
Yeah.
And it is a tremendous thing to do. And it's very satisfying to do too.
Yeah,
and if you, at the end of the day, I'm glad I've done that. Sometimes it's like, oh gosh, can I do that?
It's amazing what people can do when they're us, and it's just, and so while I'm here, are you two coming, are you helping us out at Wings? Because I've just sort of fabulous role for you both.
We'll discuss that afterwards, but I'm sure we will. Yeah. I am positive we will.
I'm trying to get their commitment on the radio, everybody. But
No, we're always willing to help wherever we can. Awesome.
So is the training for the ticket sellers and the...
So any role...
You're not just going to turn them loose on the computer.
No, definitely not that role.
Yeah, that would cause a bit of chaos. No, what we generally do is have like a team leader in each area who then trains. But that ticket selling one is funny. It's the role that's scares people the most.
Yeah.
And actually we've got a whole team of ticket managers there who help out. Yes. And what's the worst that can happen? Yeah. You give someone the wrong change
Oh,
brilliant.
Yeah. No,
going back to the campers and camper vans and all, are there any scope for tents in?
No, unfortunately aerodrome area is not zoned for camping like and that's why the motorhomes have to be fully self contained.
Yes,
so there are other options around the Wairarapa. Obviously, there's Morley Park and there's, I believe, the AMP Showgrounds, or that might be just motorhomes as well. Might be talking to you.
I don't think there is any more, is
there? Clerville's motorhomes only.
Yeah.
Not sure about Masterton.
But people will know anyway, the travel, and they'll know anyway where they can go.
Yeah, I think so. It's just, we just can't do that.
So basically, no tents under the flight path.
Ideally not. No, and no vehicles either, please.
Well, we wish you all the luck in the world.
Thank you.
Marvellous of doing this because to think of all what's involved, there's far more involved this year than ever before, especially for the children and those things that they can do.
Yeah,
might even recruit some young boys and girls for the Air Force.
Well, that's the idea. There is a shortage of pilots and absolutely. Aircraft engineers and things throughout the world. Yes. So we're trying to do our little bit here.
Yeah, yeah. So. And it's a good thing for them to go into. Not only the discipline, but it's the ethic. Yeah. It's the work ethic involved in it. And it's a wonderful... All the forces.
No, absolutely.
No, that's good. So all the best, as we say.
Thank you
so much for coming in.
Oh,
really,
thank you for inviting me. I appreciate it.
I've got to ask you one question, Jane.
Well, it sounds like a curly one. Is it going to be a curly
one? Absolutely. Have you got your pilot's licence? Oh.
You might have after that weekend.
No, I actually haven't. My husband would probably say I shouldn't have a driver's licence either, but no, I haven't. But I have been up. Many of the hangar owners down at the Hood often offer to take you up, and it's so lovely. Yeah, and I'm quite comfortable with being a backseat passenger
let somebody else do it.
Let somebody else press the buttons.
Absolutely.
Oh, it's been fun.
Awesome.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
So we'll put another piece of music on now, which is
another relevant piece of music.
Yes.
Where did this come from? It came from the film, again. And I'll find a piece of paper that tells me about it. It comes from...
It's the Dambusters March that we're going to play.
Ah, fabulous.
Which is actually written by accident for another ship. Well, it wasn't written for anything in particular. It was written by Eric Coates, who...
They wanted a march.
And he was just writing a march at the time, and it so happened that his father had been carrying out an exercise composing a march, and based on something by Edward Elgar, and he thought, that sounds good, we'll have that for the theme. So here we go.
And it's carried through for a lot of air show things.
Anything to do with aircraft,
yeah.
We now hear.
It's just been adopted, and it is a fabulous piece of music. So enjoy, folks.
You now hear this. Thank you. Right, I bet that had you all marching around the kitchen table. You're back with Arrow FM on 92.7. This is Wairarapa. And Val and I are still here after our Christmas break.
Yep.
So what do we got for the listeners
this
morning?
Well, just to finish off the show, we just thought we'd just go through a few things that are going on this coming month or so. We've got the Hoodie Hoodie Summer cycling, and one of the big things they're going to be doing, of course, is the Parkinson's event. And anything you want to know about, you go to the website www.hoodiehoodie.co.nz and find out what's happening with all the things that they're going to be doing this summer. But one of them mainly is the Parkinson's. And I've got, it's Hoodie Hoodie Summer of Cycling begins on Sunday the 17th of February at 7 a.m. till 4 p.m. and it sets off from the Martinborough Square. So that's for adults, youths as well. So just get onto that site. Hoodiehoodie.co.nz, and they'll because they've got quite a few things coming up this summer.
They have. They've got a busy program.
So if you get onto them, they'll let you know what's happening there. There's also going to be the relay for the Cancer Society are doing the relay in the country. That's going to be happening on the 16th and 17th of March. But we're telling you now because you have to get a group together. The more you've got in your group, the better. And it's going to be at the Clareville Showground here and there in Carterton. And it's an overnight walk-run relay. So get all your gang together and help the Cancer Society there. And for all info for that, you go to www.relayforlife.org.nz. Okay, now the next thing I've got is it's the last weekend this weekend to pick your own lavender in Carterton there in Dalefield Road. So they're open from 10 in the morning until 3 in the afternoon. So the last weekend is the 19th and 20th of January. So, and we went a couple of weeks ago, didn't we?
We did.
It was absolutely beautiful. I dried a lot of the lavender, and my house smells gorgeous. So yeah, get yourself along to that. And then if anyone wants any help with driving Miss Daisy, if you can't manage to get out anymore or you can't drive at all, Driving Miss Daisy is a an organisation that will be happy to help you. Their phone number is 06 377 0232 or the mobile phone is 027 310 8005. And that will be the person that will help you there is Brenda Lakeman.
Do you want to repeat that number, Val?
Okay, the number is 377-0232 and the mobile number is 027-310-8005 and Brenda Lakeman will be happy to help you. Okay, what have you got?
Lovely. I've got a couple of words of caution, actually.
Oh.
If you see myrtle rust, myrtle rust looks like, if I can get this to come up on a camera somewhere, I'm sure it will eventually. Here we go. This is what myrtle rust looks like. Now, if you see this on your plants, and I gather it's rather attacks natives, I'm not sure about rhododendrons and all that sort of thing, but if you, it's a rust that can destroy our native taonga, such as Pohutukawa, Manuka and Rata. And it also attacks Fijoa trees.
Oh, okay.
So it's now in New Zealand. If you see it, do not touch or disturb the plant.
Oh, okay.
Do not touch or disturb the plant. Take photos and call the ministry immediately on 0800 80 9966. So if you see myrtle rust that looks like this, Get help immediately. Okay. Do not touch it, because you spread it by touching it. It's an airborne fungus. Call 0800 80 99 66.
So you can't even just cut it down and burn it?
No.
You're not supposed to touch it.
No, do not touch it. Let the ministry do their job for once.
That sounds pretty.
And the other one is, we're still at war with the pea weevil. Mm-hmm. So no planting peas anywhere. That means in your garden or anywhere, no peas. And do not you import or bring any pea straw into the Wairarapa, because that can be carrying the pea weevil, and we're at war and we're determined to win it. I think this is the second year that we're at battle with it, and it's time we won it. Mm. Now, later next week, it's Cruise Martinborough time, and we've seen some beautiful machines around town.
Yeah.
There's some lovely cars. It's Cruise Martinborough. It's on Thursday through to Sunday, the 24th to the 27th of January. So I just took a quick look at the clock there. And I now want you to register now. And you need a sharp pencil for this one. www.cruisemartinborough.co.nz. So register your vintage or elderly car there. It doesn't matter what condition it's in. If it's a good specimen of the make, let's have a look at it. And here's a picture of last year's, if you can see that. Look at all those cars.
Yeah,
see?
We went, didn't we? It was fantastic. It's amazing what you say.
And not all of them are in prime condition.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the Carrington Bowling and Croquet Club. I know, bowling and croquet, I know. I hold a business hours, a twilight and barefoot bowls, would you believe, which I've never come across before.
Mm.
And you're quite happy to go along to that on, where are we, full casual bowls. Members Club Day is Tuesday and Saturday at 1:15.
Now, where are we talking about? Is that in Carterton?
In Carterton, on the High Street, behind opposite BNZ and behind Carter's. Yeah. You know, you go up by Carter's and the post office up there. And the association, yes. And they have the twilight and barefoot bowls. Thursdays at 1:15 from March to October. So that's a bit previous.
Mm-hmm.
So, and email to rob.pauline, that's rob.pauline, at outlook.com, and they'll tell you everything you need to know, and social members are very welcome.
Mm.
Now, just on our programme, this programme is recorded for podcasts, assuming I press the right buttons. I have been known to get it wrong. And the podcast is on arrowfm.co.nz under programs and show, and page your way down to Wairarapa Watch. And also the video version that goes out on Wairarapa TV is there. And we also get broadcast on Wairarapa TV, but I can't tell you what
41.
Night it is. It's on Channel 41, on Freeview Channel 41. But I've no idea what night it is because we can't get it.
No, we can't get it on our TV.
Because we're on satellite TV and they've decided they don't carry Wairarapa, among others that we would like to see. But then that's another story. So that's that one. And I don't know.
Next week? Who have we got next week, Rob?
We're talking to Victoria Jones, better known as Vicky Jones, to all those people that know her, and I'm sure there are hundreds of you out there that one way or another have met Vicky Jones.
Mm.
She was, or has been till very recently, a musician with the NZSO, and what she doesn't know about the NZSO is not available for publishing.
But she's going to come and tell us all about the history of the New Zealand Symphony Orchestra.
Plus, she's also been teaching at various song groups all around the Wairarapa.
She does lots of...
And she even did a brief stint with Star Jam, so I wanted her to tell us about that because it should be quite interesting.
Mm.
So I don't have anything else
to talk about.
I think we've pretty well come to the end of it.
Yeah.
So I'm going to play a tune that you've probably heard before, written by Henry Mancini, and today it's played by, the Melbourne Ska Orchestra. So I don't know what rhythm you're going to get to this one. Here goes. It's the... what I should do is just sign off, shouldn't I, before we turn that music loose. Mm-hmm. And you have been listening to, or have just missed, it's on the floor somewhere, Wairarapawatch on Arrow FM 92.7. And we look forward to hearing you, being with you again this time next week on Friday the 25th.
25th.
Of January.
Gosh,
already.
Already
so soon. Yeah. It's amazing how quickly the year is going.
So 9:30 till 10:30 next Friday, and we'll be talking to Vicky Jones from the NZSO.
Well, just a point that we forgot to mention on the Wings Over Wairarapa.
Oh.
No dogs. No dogs on the airfield.
Right.
So please don't bring your dog and shut it in the car for 8 hours or whatever. Mm-hmm. No dogs. Mm. And that's 100%. Would blind people go to an air show?
I don't know.
Anyway.
But there are no normal dogs are not allowed anyway.
No, pet dogs.
Blind dogs may well be.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So be aware of that, folks. No dogs.
Okay.
And as we said before, make sure you've got your ticket, because there may not be gate sales. Yeah. So here we go. You've been listening to, or have just missed, Wairarapawatch. And we'll be back next week at 9:30. Same time, same place. And here's a piece of music to cheer you up, just to get you through the morning. Come on. That's it. We'll be right back.